It's time for us to have a conversation, actually a continuation of the conversation from last week. We're looking at gifts. Now, the gifts for, this time, techie gifts for women. We did gifts for men last week, and we're going to have a conversation about gifts for women. And Philip Kofi Ashong is going to take us through that. He is the head of production here at City TV and also the host of City Trends on 97.3 City FM. Hi, Philip. What's up?
Bonjour.
What's up?
Bonjour. Well, following last week's, I got a bit of a drilling from some female colleagues.
Oh, really?
Like, why didn't we start with the girls? Women, ladies first and everything. But yeah, finally, we've gotten to the gift ideas for women. Now, the first thing, though, is whatever you're getting for a female friend, a partner, a woman, for Christmas, especially if it's a tech gift, it's not necessarily just about the functionality of it. It's about the beauty of it.
Okay.
Don't just buy it because in your mind as a guy or whoever you are, you think that functionally it's great. Think about the fact that it needs to look good as well.
Okay.
So please, like, that's a caveat for all the gift ideas I'm going to be talking about.
It has to look good.
It has to look good.
Okay.
Now, this is the reason. Like I always say, technology and tech gadgets and whatever are just an extension of an individual.
Yeah.
I'm still yet to meet any woman who doesn't like beautiful things. Mm. Beautiful things cuts across everything, whether it's the clothes or the shoes. Women like to look and feel good.
Yeah.
So if you're going to get them a gift, make sure it's a beautiful gift. Yes, it should be functional, but it must be beautiful.
Something that can be showed off.
Exactly. So please, bear that in mind anytime you have a consideration for buying a gift for a female. So let's get into the gift options.
All right.
The first one, it's a little out of character, but I'm guessing that for those who like to go for weddings, who like to hang out with friends, this would be probably a good option to go with.
Okay.
It's an instant camera.
Okay.
Yes. And I mean, there are so many manufacturers. We have everybody from Fujifilm to Kodak to Polaroid. And these are some of the examples. Now, the really cool thing about this is once you take the picture, you get the picture printed out instantly. So, you know, you can be out with your girlfriends and you can literally just print out the pictures right there and then. You don't have to wait and send it wherever. You can actually have physical evidence. It's great to have a soft copy, but there's just this... there's just this very good feel factor about having like a printed copy of a memory that you've shared with your girlfriends or with your boyfriend or whoever. So these are options from Instax. For example, there's a Mini 11. You can see the Polaroid option in the back, the Fujifilm option in the front as well. So these are some of the options that are available currently in the market. Instax is actually one of the most popular when, you know, you do your searches in most of the blog posts and things like that. So that's why it seems to appear a lot of the time. But we know Polaroid has a long history with instant pictures.
Very, very long history.
Fujifilm is also doing some pretty good work. So any of these is actually pretty okay. But this
is... Do you know when I first saw Polaroid in like instant camera? It must have been like 1985. 84, 85. I just saw one photo coming out and I'm like, huh? How does the photo just come out like that?
I should tell you how old Quick is.
Forget about that. I don't know what other gifts.
1985.
I don't know how many gifts that you're gonna present, but I think this is the pick.
This and that's why I chose that.
Ladies just love
the
whole photo thing.
And you see, it's about the creation of memories. It's about the preservation of memories. You know, whether you've gone out to Dubai for a holiday or you've gone out to lunch with your girlfriends, whatever it is, it's all about creating and preserving memories. And I think that's one of the best ways to do that. You get to see the picture you've taken.
Right away.
You know, you can take multiple shots where everybody keeps a copy.
Yeah.
And it's just great. Something you keep in a scrapbook, something you can, you know, put in a frame, however you want to keep it. This is, you know, one of the best options to go with. Now, later on, we'll be talking about a portable printer as well that I found that I thought was pretty cool. But we'll come to that in a bit. The second one is a pretty simple little tool. But I found it very, very efficient. It's a phone grip.
Okay.
A phone grip.
Okay.
It might not necessarily be the most techie thing in the world, but it's such a functional thing. And once again, you have to think about how beautiful it looks. Now, I mean, these are just options available on the market. Okay. You can just buy. Some people actually print, you know, the designed bit of it. Some people actually print their own options and then, you know, whatever. But, I mean, for me, this is one of my favorite, my personal favorite. Now, you can see it acts as both a kickstand, depending on how you... you eject it, and then it can be a phone grip as well. Now, the reason why a phone grip is really great is because, you know, sometimes depending on the size of the phone, like you're typing and you want to do a one-hand operation and it's slipping out of your hand, so you have to use two hands to support it. But with a phone grip, you can literally just hold the device in just one hand and operate it as you will. Now, if it comes along as a kickstand, with a kickstand, as you can see in this example, in this one, for example, I mean, it's even better. You can just prop it up on, you know, on the table or on a set of books if you are doing like a Zoom call, you know, or something like that. And you don't need to buy all these fancy, you know, little gimmicky things as well. So these are some of the options that are available on the market as we speak. This is also one of my little favorites. I like it because of the color options. I like it because of how slim it is. It kind of like fits with the device.
Looks good.
So yeah, it looks really good. Like I said, it must look beautiful.
It has to look beautiful
if it's a gift for a woman. So, I mean, these are some of the options available in the market. Some of them are magnetic. Some of them are just like this, which, you know, come with a case or something. Okay. Or you can just slap on the back of a phone. But I just feel that these phone grips are really, really good. Some of them come in the vehicles, as will be seen in a couple of seconds. You know, this one, for example, it's almost like a ring, and then you can just, you know, slot your hand around it. You know, you can be walking and you just hold on to it, and you're pretty good to go. These ones are also, they have like sort of like a magnetic bit in the car, so you can just basically prop up, you know, and then it just sticks. Some of them I've seen now also act as wireless chargers. You know, so, you know, I mean, it's evolution and it changes. But, I mean, the simplest is usually the best. Just get something that is nice, something that is functional. And as you can see there, it has so many different options. You know, you can just slot your fingers in it, use it for one-hand operation, or it can be in the car, you know, where it can help you, you know, in terms of directions, you know, so you don't have to be holding your phone physically. You know, it has so many, so many benefits. And like I said, it has to look good.
Absolutely.
And for me, the two of my favorites are the first one that we saw, which has, you know, the Interstellar, the galaxy thingy. And then the very slim one that we saw there with the multiple colors. I think for me, those two really, really work. So yes, a phone grip is your second option. The third option in terms of a gift option is a tablet.
Okay.
Now, someone might ask, I mean, really, what's the point of a tablet? Now, the thing is, people are mobile these days. Sometimes people want to send their laptops. But then in order to be a little more efficient, you would want to send a device that is not necessarily a laptop and is not restricted in terms of its size like a phone. So a tablet sort of sits very well in between the two. Now, a few things of caution. If the person you are gifting a tablet to is a very, very busy person, goes to a lot of meetings, requires to do a lot of typing, my suggestion is that look for a tablet that comes with a keyboard.
Okay.
Or if you can get a tablet that comes with a keyboard and a trackpad, even better. But then look, once again, like we said last week, look at the lifestyle of the person before you purchase the device. And once again, it goes without saying, make sure the device is looking good. Now, if it's looking good, it usually, I mean, almost all the devices look the same, but then it's all about the case that you buy for the device. And that's where the magic is. If you have a really good looking case, Swedish case, you know, some of the cases actually come with the built-in keyboard. So, you know, that's pretty easy for you to work around, you know, so you do have that option and you can either get, you know, the Samsung Tab S7 that we talked about earlier in the year. There's the Apple and the range of iPads from the iPad mini to the iPad, you know, generation 8 to the iPad Pro. There's all of that. There are quite a number of tablet options available. There's, of course, the Microsoft Surface Pro and, you know, all those others. Now, thing is, once again, look into the eyes of the person. Are they already using an Android ecosystem or are they into iPad or Apple ecosystem? Look into that. You know, look at the functionality. Would they want a tablet that you can easily slot a pen drive into or an SD card into? Are they a photographer, for example?
Okay.
Would they need a slot for an SD card? These are some of the things that you should look at before you make a purchase for a laptop for a female. Because if it's not functional, Yeah. I mean, there's no point for them to have it. Yeah. If it's not beautiful, there's no point of them having it. It might be a great present because you spent a lot of money on it, but then if she doesn't use it, then there's no point for you to have even, you know, spent your money on buying it. So look at the person's life and then decide on, okay, so the person, for example, is a photographer. What it means is that they need a very good screen with which they're going to edit. They need a very fast tablet that they're going to work with. Mm. They need an input for an SD card in case they finish taking their pictures. Yeah. So these are some of the things that you should be thinking about. If, for example, they are an office person, you're thinking about, okay, they go to a lot of meetings, don't need to do a lot of typing. Yeah. Maybe typing on the tablet itself, on the screen itself, might not be the most efficient. So you get them a case which has a keyboard, or some of the tablets actually come already with the keyboard and everything. So you're pretty much sorted in terms of that. So just consider the person's life and how useful it will be in their life. And if you get 2 out of 5 or 3 out of 5 in terms of how useful it will be, guess what? They would really, really appreciate it, because it's a very, very thoughtful gift to have. You know, you don't have to, you know, carry along your laptop, your 15-inch fat laptop everywhere you go. If you're traveling, sometimes it's a bit cumbersome. Yeah. But then, you know, if you have a tablet, a 12-inch, 11-inch, a 9-inch, or an 8-inch tablet, you know, it's just really, really nice to have. Yeah. You go anywhere you want with it, and you're pretty good to go. So, I mean, these are the first three. And the next one is a smartwatch. Now, there are a few things about smartwatches. First of all, it looks nice, but once again, it must be functional.
Okay.
Because if it is not functional, then it is pointless. The person might as well use their everyday watch. Now, most of the smartwatches that we see today, now look at that. Like, it's just beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
It's just gorgeous. Yeah. I mean, and there are so many options available. Mm. Fossil has a number of them. Samsung, as you can see. Fitbit, as you can see. Fitbit Versa 3. Apple has the, you know, Apple Watch and everything. Yeah. So there are so many options available. Now, just a couple of things that I need you to note about the smartwatches. Firstly, almost all of them are fitness trackers. Okay. So, I mean, it just kind of makes sense. You know, I mean, some of them might not, but I think 90% of smartwatches are also fitness trackers. So then it is a very viable device to have in terms of giving the person, you know, some options in terms of monitoring, you know, the number of steps, their cardio, their whatever. The ecosystems are different naturally, but I mean, generally, most smartwatches are also doubling as fitness trackers. The second thing for me, the most important thing I feel, is that look at the smartwatches that you're going to purchase. If it's for a female, try as much as possible to get a smartwatch that has a period tracker as well inbuilt. Okay.
That makes a lot of sense.
That is, for me, the biggest in terms of options you should consider. Yeah. If it doesn't have a period tracker, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with it. I think there's something missing, especially if it's a gift for a woman.
For a woman,
because look, it's important. They think about these things, they worry about these things, they think about it, they have to notice sometimes in a notebook, sometimes they forget, sometimes they download all these plenty apps just to monitor. But then if it is right there on their wrist, they can see it, they can monitor it, like they are okay. So I think that if you're going to get a smartwatch for a female, I think one of the first considerations, apart from how beautiful it looks, should be that it should have a period tracker as well. Yeah. And quite a number of the watches now, the smartwatches now have that, you know. So look across, but make sure you ask that simple question. Does it have a period tracker? If it doesn't, look for other options. Okay. Because it must yes, look good, but it must be functional for the person who's going to use it. And in this case, it's a woman. So, hey, it just goes without saying. Yeah. Make sure you ask that question to the person you're buying it from. Mm-hmm. Make sure you can, like, Google it. Google the smartwatch you're going to buy and make sure that it has the period tracker.
Yeah.
The next one is a Bluetooth speaker.
Okay.
Now, there are two levels to this. There is the Bluetooth speaker that you are seeing on the screen right now, which is the main reason why I even want to talk about it, is that it should be waterproof.
Okay.
Now, the reason why I should be waterproof is like they can play the music while they're taking a shower. You know, like sometimes,
I like the idea.
Sometimes, you know, you just want to take a long shower after a very long day.
Yeah.
You just want to chill. You just want to have some fun. You just want to just relax, whether it's a bath or it is a shower, whichever one it is. if you have a Bluetooth speaker, usually has a few suction cups or whatever next to it. You can just stick it to the wall, stick it to the door, or whatever, and just play your music, relaxing music, Kenny G kind of music, you know, Case kind of music, just sit back, Joe kind of music.
Cafe
just
lounge.
Just relax and just give her the option of having it. If it's not waterproof, what it means is probably the water is going to go into places it shouldn't go and destroy it. But if it's waterproof, she can stick it anywhere in the bathroom, you know, and just have a wonderful shower or a bath, and she's good. She's good. She doesn't even have to worry about splashing water over it and destroying it or getting electrocuted because of whatever. So for me, if you're going to get a Bluetooth speaker, I think that you should try and get, and these are options. These are JBLs. These are, exactly. You know, these are JBLs that you can also consider. There are quite a number of, you know, options available on the market. But for me, I think if you're going to get a Bluetooth speaker, try and make it. Now, try and make it like a waterproof one. Now, if you're not going to get a waterproof one, then you must get one that looks awesome, that looks really sexy. And for me, like, look at that retro look. It has that retro, still modern type of look, you know. So if you're not going to get a Bluetooth speaker, at least get one that looks good and it's still functional, you know. So, and these are just some of the options.
Okay.
See, like, how really, really cool it looks and everything. And all these are just Bluetooth speakers. Mm. So these are also waterproof. You can take to the pool and things like that with your friends. So, look, Bluetooth speakers, great. But first priority, I think, should be waterproof. Mm. Just because of where it will be used and how to be used and things like that. But then if you can't get a waterproof one, get one of these. Make sure it looks great and it sounds great. Otherwise, don't bother yourself. Like, just don't bother yourself. Now, I told you that there was one more thing that I wanted us to look at, and that is a printer for your pictures. So we initially talked about the instant camera, which, you know, is great. It's brilliant. But what if you have different friends wanting to print a picture at the same time? What if the pictures that were taken on Amir's phone is so much better than the one I was taking on Lydia's phone? What do you do? That is where this nifty, sexy-looking device comes into play. It's called the Sprocket. It comes from HP. There are a number of other printers. I chose the Sprocket because look at that.
Oh,
look at the marble look of that. Look at beauty. Yes, please.
Oh, wow.
Yes, please. Look at that marble beauty.
Okay.
Yes, please. So the Sprocket is the little add-on that I just wanted to... I mean, there are other printers, but this looks great. You know, like, you can connect different... once the app is downloaded onto it, you know, you guys went out, someone took much better pictures than you. Probably, you know, all your pictures were blurred and everything. I mean, you can print it and slot it into, you know, a frame or something like that. But the Sprocket, for me, is one of the best options that you can find. And that's it in its case. You know, it's that small, it's that portable. It comes in different sizes. And then all you basically have to do is just connect it. And you can see the different sizes there. You know, the different sizes of the Sprocket. And you can see printing from the phone.
Yeah.
And you're just good to go. So your friends connect with it via Bluetooth or via whichever.
So it's literally as large as the phone.
Wi-Fi. And then you just go. I mean, the last one obviously is a little bigger, it's just a fun thing to have. Mm. It has portable power inside it, so you know you can take it wherever you want. Yeah. It comes with a film that you know basically produces the pictures as awesome as they look. It has inbuilt picture editing options, so you can even edit the pictures before they are printed. And these are right there, you know, just take the picture and go, you know, and everybody can choose. You can choose to print three or four of the same picture, so everybody has one. Look, the options are there, and it's by HP. It's one of the things that I found really, really awesome. You know, you should consider. These are just options available on the market, you know. But it should be beautiful.
Well,
if it's not beautiful, don't buy it.
All I can say is that yet again, once again, the women have eclipsed us in terms of
however,
what it is that they are.
Before we go,
there's
just one more device that I think a lot of people overlook. And it is this.
What's that?
An external hard drive.
Okay.
I think that by far, an external hard drive is one of the best things you can get.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll always advocate that you go for an SSD, which is a solid state drive, because it's faster, it's safer, everything. But even if it's an HDD, it doesn't really matter. get someone in your life an external hard drive. 2 terabytes, 1 terabyte, 500 gig, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Why should you? Because everybody has memories. Men, women. Mm. Women take a lot of pictures, relatively. Mm. You don't need to do any research to prove it.
Yeah.
But women relatively take more pictures than men do.
Yeah.
No, whether it is on their phone that they are keeping it, on their laptop that they are keeping it, wherever it is, they take a lot of videos. One thing that people hate to do, women hate to do, is delete nice pictures.
Yeah.
Now, if they don't have anywhere else to keep it, they will have to delete it.
Yeah.
So get them a place to keep it. And it's on an external. You just need to spend about 300 CDs getting an external for, you know, your wife or your girlfriend or your sister. And just walk her through, or she probably even knows how to just transfer all her photos, all her videos onto an external. She can do this every quarter. She can do this half a year. It doesn't matter. What matters is that she has a safe place to where she can close her eyes and know that all her material is safe. If she can't print it with the sprocket or whichever, she can just save it here. And she can do whatever she wants with
later
it
on.
At any point in time. So, those are the gift options that I have for the ladies in our lives.
Well, thank you very much, Philip Kopiashaw, for bringing those beautiful ideas to us. Yet again, the women have eclipsed the men.
Hi there. We hope you enjoyed the show.
Make sure to subscribe, like, comment, and share with your friends.
This is Breakfast Daily on City TV.
Join the Breakfast Daily team Monday through Fridays from 7:30 a.m. to 10. Join us for breakfast daily, only on City TV.